in Shortland Street.
Foreigners is a hard working, they're very experienced.
In everything except the English language. I don't want chaos on my wards.
As you know, we've been short staffed for a while now, and nothing has been done about it. And nurses are going down like flies. Look, it's not a personal thing. I'm worried about the department.
And I'm not?
I didn't say that.
In future, talk to me first.
And on top of that, I've had three nurses call in sick.
I know this is a difficult time. I'm doing all I can to ease things up.
Well, you haven't employed any overseas nurses and you haven't shut any beds.
I've pulled in all the bureau staff I can get, plus we'll have five graduates starting next week.
Learner drivers, great help.
They will be, actually.
We need experienced registered nurses and we need them now. This is the surgical ward's busiest day.
Which is why I've made sure that Maya's got three of her regular staff, plus a healthcare assistant, and I've assigned you to help out. That should be enough.
It's a waste of my time. I'm meant to be training theatre staff.
Except you're more used to me on the surgical ward. This is about teamwork, Brenda. It'd help if you stop being so obstructive.
I am not being obstructive. I'm trying to suggest solutions, but you don't seem to want to hear them.
Let's just try and put up a united front, shall we? Get on with it. Maya, can I have a quick word?
Of course.
Morning, everyone. I just wanted to take a minute to say how much I appreciate all the hard work the surgical ward staff have been putting in during the nursing shortage. I know it's been a strain, but I promise it'll soon be over.
How soon?
We've got five new grads starting next week.
New grads?
Swatty, energetic, really keen. Once they've been through orientation, they'll be huge help. Of course, I'm still looking for experienced nurses, so if you know anyone...
Don't worry, we'll get right back to you.
Have a good day, people. When all this is over, morning tea's on management. If you need me, I'll be in AD for most of the day.
Right, everyone. It's full on the wards today, so I've divided up patients according to acuity. Baxter, you've got Mr. Kerr in room one, and in room three, you've got a new admission, Mrs. June Banks. She's scheduled for a thyroidectomy later today.
Gotcha.
Tanya, you've got Mr. Sanjay Patel in room two, acute appendectomy. He was transferred from recovery at about 4 a.m. and he's been vomiting ever since.
Great.
Yeah. You've also got room four, the same three patients as yesterday. Tans, that's you, Mr. Patel.
See you.
Right. Laura, you've got rooms five and six. I'll help you with your IV antibiotics as soon as I'm done here.
Right.
And Doreen, hi. This is Doreen, everyone. She is a healthcare assistant from Clover Nursing Bureau. I'm sure everyone will make you feel welcome. Doreen, I need you to watch Louise Nelson. Now, she is in room three. That's one of Baxter's. Louise is 10 days post-hip replacement due to go to rehab. She needs a constant eye. She has a history of dementia and tends to wander.
Okay.
I'll show you where to go.
Cheers.
And I'll be around too if you need an extra pair of hands. I'm Brenda.
Hi.
Okay, so that's it, everyone. It's busy, we're all tired, so just pace yourselves and good luck.
You'll need it.
Drugs aren't working. Need something else.
Mr. Patel, have you passed any urine since your operation? Would you like to try now?
What do you think?
Is your abdomen sore at all?
Mouth so dry. Do something, another drug?
You've already had regular antiemetics. I'm worried you're dehydrated. I'll need to speak to the doctor.
Just go on then, just hurry up.
So she gets around well on her walking frame and she can shower independently, but you have to watch her closely for safety reasons.
Understand.
Good morning, Louise.
Hello.
This is Doreen. She's going to be keeping you company today.
Oh, lovely.
Just give us a shout if you need anything. Good morning, I'm Baxter.
Hi.
Can you tell me your name, please?
June Banks.
Okay, June, and what's your address?
15 Clifton Road, Ferndale.
And you're in for a thyroidectomy operation today, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, and have you been into hospital before?
last year with dizziness and headaches. I've got high blood pressure.
Right, and are you taking any medication for it?
Every morning, 4 pills, 1 pink, 1 blue, and 2 white.
I'm sorry, but I'm going to have to go get that buzzer. I'll be right back.
I mean, it's all very well for Tony to thank us, but it doesn't help us deal with the madness, does it?
Well, the worst thing for me is it never needed to get this bad.
I know. I couldn't believe it when she said she was reopening those orthopaedic beds. I mean, what was she thinking?
Well, she wasn't. Someone else was playing that tune. She just danced along.
Mm. 1.2 milligrams of amoxicillin, expiry 308.
Yep, good. You know, if it was left to me, I'd have this ward fully staffed with experienced nurses by lunchtime.
I thought there was no one around.
That's not how Libby tells it. She sourced a whole team of experienced overseas nurses. Now, you tell me why Tony's not taking them on.
Are you saying that?
I'm just saying they're legal and available, but they're not here.
Has Justine phoned back?
No.
I left her a message. Mr. Patel.
Anya, that's you, Mr. Patel.
He won't leave me alone. He's still throwing up and none of the drugs he's been charted are helping. I can't give him anything else without seeing Justine. Look, he's going crazy. He'll bite my head off.
Oh, he'll drive us all crazy if he doesn't stop buzzing.
Give me the chart. I'll find Justine. You go and calm him down.
Easy said.
I'll get on with this drug round.
Yeah, well, you can. Surgical nurse's station, Brenda speaking.
Mrs. Banks. Mrs. Banks, we need you to take your pills. Your pills? We need you to take them before we prep you for theatre. Here you go.
How long now?
You're second on the list this afternoon. I'll come and get you ready soon. Mrs. Banks, do you know where Mrs. Nelson's gone? The lady from the bed next door.
Mr. Patel needs another liter of saline over 6 hours and IV droperidol for his nausea.
We don't have any of that on the ward. I'll have to send down to the pharmacy.
As soon as possible. The poor man's wrung out.
Oh, I need to find an orderly first. They're not sick on the ground.
No, I'll dash down and get it myself. That'll be way quicker.
I need you here.
You haven't seen Mr. Patel. He needs his medicine more. I'll be 10 minutes, tops.
Okay, well, don't get distracted.
I won't.
Oh, there's Mr. Patel again. Baxter, could you go and tell
us... I need him. I just reviewed Mrs. Murdoch's scans and I'm taking her to theatre straight after Mrs. Banks, but there's no sign of any pre-op bloods.
Murdoch, that's not one of mine.
She has room for, that's Tanya. Oh, she's on a mercy dash to the pharmacy.
Okay, sweet, I'll do it then.
Thanks, Bax.
Hey, Maya, you haven't seen Doreen, have you? She's disappeared somewhere with Mrs. Nelson.
She might have taken her for a shower. She didn't have one this morning.
Oh, good call.
It's Mr. Patel again. This is getting out of hand.